Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I remember my ustad, Mullah Fadl Rahim, rahimahullah, may Allah give him the best of the akhirah, best of the next world. I remember him saying, and I'm actually sitting at this moment in Oldham, funny enough, in the city that the Shaykh used to live in. And this is a reminder for all of us that he used to say that there are many ways to reach Allah Azza wa Jal, many ways to reach Allah Azza wa Jal. And sometimes a person thinks that he's going to reach Allah in one way, but Allah wants him to reach him in a different way, so he takes him through a different route. So Shaykh was saying that, you know, he spent so many years striving to get close to Allah in you know, with so many different methods. And he got very disappointed at one time because he wasn't just getting there, you know, it wasn't just happening. This is Mullah Fadl Rahim, rahimahullah. And he said he met this other sheikh where he spent 40 days with him, and he reached so much in those 40 days that he never reached in so many years. Okay, and he said that, you know, Allah Azza wa Jal has got, you know, he says lanahdiyannahum subulana. The last verse of Surah Ankabut is that walladhina jahadu fina, whoever strives to get to us, to find us. I mean, Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, whoever strives to find me or get to me, then Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا, then I will, you know, I will guide them to my many paths. The ayah says there are many paths to get to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So what Mawlana Fadl Rahim, rahimahullah, said is that so many paths there are to get to Allah. He said there's more than the hair on the back of a sheep. There's more pathways to Allah than the hair on the back of a sheep. And sometimes what Allah does is he can make someone come so close without any effort. Without any effort. Allah can just bless someone and he can make them come really close to him. So he said, what's most important is this, and I want you to take away this, and I want you to make dua with this today. He said, what Allah is looking for in people is he wants them to come to him with, you know, without any status. He wants them to come without any demands, without feeling that they are great, without making, you know, without making themselves feel that we are someone, you know, I'm worth something. He said, people need to understand the secret to get to Allah, which is you need to come to Allah with a broken heart. You need to come to Allah with an empty heart, with a heart that feels that you've got nothing. The moment he says you come to Allah with a heart where you actually believe you've got nothing and that Allah has everything, the moment you do that, you've cracked the secret of getting Allah's attention. Because that's what Allah wants. Allah wants servants to come feeling that they've got nothing. And you know what? We haven't got anything. Who are we? Who do we feel that we are? Who do we think we are? So this idz and making yourself feel really humble in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, he said that's the real secret in most ibadah to reach Allah Azza wa Jal. And anyone who's reached Allah, you know, it's for a reason that Allah liked about them. And one of the best things Allah likes is that you come to him feeling that you've got nothing, you're broke, you know, you really need him. That humbleness is the best and the fastest way to get to Allah Azza wa Jal. So when you make dua today before iftar, when you make, you know, when you try to get close to Allah Azza wa Jal throughout this Ramadan, try and feel that inside yourself, that you need Allah the most, you've got nothing, break yourself inside, come humbly in front of Allah, and inshallah Allah Azza wa Jal will fill your heart up, and he will make you come closer to him, inshallah. And don't forget, there are many ways to get close to Allah, and he will take you through one of the ways, inshallah, and make you come. As long as you've got your heart there, Allah will bring you there, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Make dua for me too. And of course, in the link, there's the we're still raising, you know, donation for the app that we've created. It's out there on Play Store. It's out there, you know, on the App Store. So you can find it, you can download it. But those of you who can donate, please, we're asking you to donate. May Allah Azza wa Jalla fill your scales on the Day of Judgment with a lot of hasanat, with a lot of reward. And may Allah make your dunya and make your akhirah. May Allah make you find the pathway to Allah Azza wa Jalla as well. Our du'as are there with you. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.